All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to episode 22 of Honor Radio. And today we got a great friend in our studio, Casey Taylor, and a state champion winning coach. And we are excited. Welcome to Honor Radio. Casey, I got to tell you, buddy, it is amazing to have you on our radio show. I've been wanting to get you on the show for years, ever since we started this, my friend. And, you know, buddy, since the beginning of the Honor Bowl, we're talking back battle at the Capitol, battle for veterans, then the Honor Bowl. You were one of the inspirational guys that got us started. What do you remember about all that, Case?
Well, I remember seeing you at Folsom High School. There was some games going on, a couple showcase games that weekend. And I know it was getting close to the 10-year anniversary of 9-11. And I'm not a good math guy because I think I was off a year or so. But I was just really moved by your boys. There was an article in the paper about them serving and coming back and those types of things. And my dad was a Vietnam veteran, came back and struggled a little bit when he got back. My grandpa was at Pearl Harbor on the West Virginia, was a Navy guy. So the military was a big part of me, patriotic and that. But I just really want to do something special for the cause. You know, I think the veterans and the way they treat when they get back, especially when my dad came back, and now this new wave of younger veterans coming back in, and with your boys inspiring me, I felt like, you know, it was a great cause that we really needed to bring some awareness to our veterans and kind of help them out through some stuff. And I was thinking to have maybe one game over at Del Oro, but you know, with you jumping aboard and getting all excited and turning into what it is today has just been outstanding. I feel really honored to be a part of it. I feel blessed to, you know, have you guys bring me in and let me do my small part with it. But it's just been a great cause, and it's a game every year, you know, with some military appreciation. If I was in the Honor Bowl or did it on my own, I think it's a great week. I love to reflect on my dad, my grandpa, and just all the sacrifices all of our veterans have made around the, you know, through test of times, present, you know, the future people, past. You know, and then just the journey with the Honor Bowl, it's been outstanding. I have an opportunities to meet veterans of all different ages and people in your community, people around the state, be able to visit wounded warriors down at Camp Pendleton and those types of things, and just kind of seeing their struggles firsthand. And it really inspired a lot of our kids at Del Oro, especially when I was there. We had probably a dozen kids that went into the service for, you know, if it was an academy thing. Some guys, we were fortunate to go to the Air Force Academy or, you know, West Point or something like that. But we also had guys enroll and, you know, hit the front lines. So it's really been a big major impact, I feel, for me. And just one of the great causes, I feel, and one of the great events you guys put on. But just the cause is so important to me and hits home with my family. So, like I said, I've been honored to be a part of it.
You know, Casey, I'll never forget that day when we first met. I think it was at a clinic in Reno, and you and I had lunch, and we started talking, and you said, "Hey, I got this idea." And I took this idea, and I remember you were thinking that it was going to be more about, you know, just a flag at the beginning of the game and a Star Spangled Banner, but I don't think you had any idea that I saw this as something that could be so much bigger, right? Yeah, and then we roll out, you know, the battle at the Capitol, which at the time, that's what it was called. And we went down and visited wounded warriors and had them do a tape, which Rick, the producer of Honor Radio, did a documentary about, which went, you know, all throughout the nation. And then the Honor Bowl just started growing and growing. And you stuck by us, my friend, through all those difficult, growing, hard times. You know, you would bring your team down to San Diego and play some of the best as the event started growing, and you go to Camp Pendleton. It was, buddy, I got to tell you, you have just been an amazing friend. And to follow your career path from, you know, Del Oro High School, state champion, you know, winning coach at Del Oro, then on to Capital Christian and now to Inderkum. We'll talk a little bit more about that. Buddy, it's an honor to have you on this show and to be your friend.
Well, I appreciate it. I feel the same for you, Mark. You guys do a tremendous job and a great friend throughout. And like I said, I appreciate you having me on.
So, you know, let's talk a little bit about what's been happening with you. You know, you had a great experience at Del Oro, already said, won the state championship, went several times to the state championship. One time you won it, a perennial great coach. Your program was one of the best in the country, right? And then you decide to take a leap to another school. Capital Christian started growing that program. And then a couple of years or months, weeks ago, we hear that you're now leaving Capital and going to another school. How's that all going for you, Case?
Well, it's been a crazy month, to be honest about it. You know, like you said, I was very fortunate to be at Del Oro High School for 15 years and a great place. I just, you know, we did some place for 15 years, felt like just needed kind of a change, kind of felt like I've taken the program to a certain level. I did a lot of work with Capital Christian with their Evening of Dreams and some character combine and some other events, and was really growing in my faith. And I just felt like I was called to go over there. You know, they really wanted to build up a big program, and I felt, hey, this is a great opportunity to work with a different types of kids, more of an urban school, which I was excited about, and going over there and making a difference in a new community with the church. And we did a great job over there, kind of building it up. I was there 3 years, and you know, we won 30 games. We made the playoffs and we didn't lose a league game while I was over there. On my second year, we won the section championship, and moved up to Division III. They were Division V before I got there, so we got a Division III championship. And then last year, we lost in the semifinals, but I was real proud. Our team won the academic. We had the highest GPA in the section, so that was the first time I won a section for academics. So real proud of what we were building over there, where we were going, you know, kind of going through some stuff, trying to make that work. Well, you know, with there were some furloughs. I got contacted on a Tuesday, and Friday was going to be my last paycheck. And so it kind of throws you into a spin of survival and, wow, what am I going to do, especially the times we're in right now with this virus. Mm-hmm. It's not a great time as a teacher to probably go find a job. Last thing I worry about when nobody's at school's teaching. So I was very fortunate. A lot of people reached out, a lot of good people that you know, were looking out for me. I had some opportunities, but Inderkum really stepped up to the plate. They got it real quickly. They got me on staff, got me in. Terry Stark, who had been there, retired.
Great guy.
Had a lot of success. So from afar, I've always looked at that school. They've always had a lot of talent, and they've always won a lot of games. And it seems like they're getting to the semifinals and the finals all the time. Just can't seem to get over the hump. So I just felt when that opened up, the timing was outstanding, and have an opportunity to go over there and, you know, add on to what Terry has done and really, you know, take the program to that next level, you know, and really get involved in the community and really build. I'm really excited. So this last month, that's kind of what I've been doing, these Zoom calls and things like that, trying to gather information and that type of stuff.
Have you had a chance, Casey, at all to meet any of the players? I mean, has you had any chance to do that at all?
Yeah, I've had a Zoom call with them, you know, but it's hard with, 30, 40 faces on there trying to tell them what you are. But that's what we're going to start doing, kind of meeting through Zoom. And obviously it's unique times. It's kind of a, you know, weird place where we're at. But, uh-huh. You know, doing our best to work through it and, you know, can't wait to get back.
You got to get somebody. So any ideas? Are you hearing anything about when you can get back? Has there been anything you're hearing in that line?
Not a ton. You know, June 1st is obviously one, but I don't know if that's going to be the case. There's talk of getting rid of the NorCal games and the state games and possibly going back to section championships like we did in the past. Yeah. So I think they feel if they do that, it would be a like September 20th date, you know, could be the first games. Mm-hmm. And then I've heard possibly October 2nd, if they cut it to 8 games, we could start October 2nd to get a season in. So, you know, a lot of it's just moving parts and kind of up in the air. So,
yeah.
See.
Hey, I got a question for you, Coach. Yeah. This is Rick. I'm the guy behind the curtain. So you've heard that about possibly changing the dates around the October 2nd. So it would basically start as a pre-league October 2nd?
Yeah, I'm hearing like an 8-week season. So I don't know exactly where that would be with the 0 week, but they could get 8 games in if they started on October 2nd and have the section finals I believe that second or third week of December. You know, I think it's the 14th or 15th. I don't know what date it is, but that was one of their proposals they're looking at. I did know that they said that they will not move the football season, so they wouldn't move it to the fall in the spring or the winter. So if it couldn't go, it couldn't go. But that's what I think they're, you know, that'll probably be. So, you know, obviously I'm hoping for June 1st, but, you know, I don't know if that'll be the case. Football's unique too because of that acclimatization period. You know, it takes 3 weeks to kind of get to that date. So I guess you go 3 weeks back from October 2nd or September. You know, the September start makes sense to me. It's kind of how it was for years. We start way early, I feel, anyway, in July. But that October 2nd one would be interesting too. But, you know, it sounds like you got to be in school to have an opportunity to play athletics. So it'll be interesting with that, you know, how different districts maybe handle the school, you know. So if there was a district that said, yeah, you could go to school, and another district said, you know, they're going online. It'll be interesting kind of see how those things plan out. They've kind of talked about that, kind of doing some mini realignment if some schools do or not. But I feel like it'll be county mandated or state mandated, I'm sure. You know, we're all kind of in the same boat, I would think. I don't know.
You know, Casey, you're inheriting a program that we talked already briefly about it, but they went 11-1 last year, lost in the semis, I believe, to Oak Ridge, if I'm right.
Yep.
Right. And almost made it to the regional championship, right?
Yep.
You're not inheriting a small program. This is a program that is definitely on the rise. And, you know, I know that you're just frothing to get a hold of it. What do you know about some of your returning athletes?
You know, just kind of talking to the coaches. I know we got a lot of good athletes and good numbers. I think that's going to be something that, you know, was hard at Capital, having low numbers like we had, you know. So I'm looking forward to, you know, having 40-plus on the freshman JV and varsity team, which will be nice. You know, there's 2,300 kids at the school. It's a big school. Yeah. It's a beautiful school. It's a newer school.
Yeah.
And I was just really fired up that the principal was, you know, fired up about the football program, you know, the athletic director was all into it. When I went over there for kind of finalized things, the superintendent was there and the district athletic director. So, you know, I feel like when, you know, you got some key people in the district making this happen and kind of getting it going and asking questions and taking time out of their day in this hectic time of quarantine and all those types of things, it really meant a lot to me for them to get me on the way they did. So I think they really want to continue to build on what they've done, but, you know, also take the program to another level and hopefully bring home the first section championship to Inderkum High School. That's the goal.
Oh, I love it. You got two, buddy. Yeah. So, you know, I got to tell you, Casey, you're a big find. I'm sure the superintendent and all of them being there to meet you was, you know, hey, man, this is Casey. He's coming to be a part of our program. And so I'm sure they're pretty excited about that, my friend. On a personal level, how's the family doing? I know you have a young daughter that's at Del Oro. You got another young man that's in high school. How's the family doing with all of this COVID thing going on?
We're hanging in there. You know, I think, we were in about 4 or 5 days when we got let go over at Capital. So it was kind of thrust right in. And it's really been football's just been a huge family for us. My wife, Janie, has been just so supportive in everything we do. And I'm so thankful on that. And then my daughter, Jaden, is a junior over at Del Oro. They're doing, you know, online learning as well. And then Jackson's a seventh grader at Capital, finishing up over there online. So they've done a good job, but, you know, they're bored. They want to get out and do stuff. You know, we're lucky we have a nice backyard. So every once in a while you can sneak out by the pool. We've had some nice weather where you kind of think you're getting away from it for a little bit, but, you know, just trying to control what we can control. You know, they're doing their work, turning stuff in, but we're doing good on that end with everything. Everybody's doing good, but it's crazy. It's just a crazy time and everybody's stir crazy. And we just want to get back to the normal. You know, that's really what we want to do and get out. And we're people persons that have people over. We love family and friends, and to not be able to socialize and do that's been really hard on us. But like I said, it's been great going through this process with them, and they were a big part of going and touring and seeing and meeting people and kind of doing that, because this is a family thing for us. Football, it's a lifestyle, it really is. So it's affects everybody, and that's what's hard when you leave. You know, when I did leave Del Oro, you know, people, you know, how does it affect you or this? It affects the whole family. It's really hard. You know, me and my son went over to Capital, so it was kind of a new thing. My daughter stayed at Del Oro, but like my wife was kind of caught in both. You know, we still had a student at Del Oro. We still were at Capital, and everywhere we went, you know, go to church or wherever we went, they're always talking about football. You know, we just want to be, you know, didn't want that, you know, so it really affects things, you know, but I think about my family. They know it's the lifestyle. We won't be at all the Inderkum events and be in there and really go like we did at Del Oro. We want to bring special events like the Honor Bowl to Inderkum and really make an impact not only on the campus but in that community and really you know, get involved in some of the things going on out there. So we're real excited for the opportunity, and I got about 10 or 15 more years left, so you know, we're looking to put a real good run, like to run together kind of similar to what we did at Del Oro, and
yeah,
you know, then right off, you know.
Well, I got to tell you, Case, they picked the right guy. You know, this whole COVID thing has just got everybody, I mean, up in arms. We've been talking with a lot of coaches. We had 20 high schools involved in the Honor Bowl this year. We're still, Rick and I are still wondering whether we're going to have an Honor Bowl. I mean, we don't know if there's going to be a preseason. I mean, obviously, if we go to an 8, you know, game format, that's probably going to tube the Honor Bowl altogether, and we'll just come back in 2021 with the 9/11 Honor Bowl, which will be the 20-year anniversary, which we already were starting to work on. We were already contracting teams for 2021, but this is just it's a rough time. It's a rough time, and I'm looking forward to getting back to normal.
No doubt about it. You know, so I think everybody is, and you know, I hope we get back in time so we can have special events like the Honor Bowl in there. But like you said, the cause is, you know, we can find ways to keep the cause going, and you know, and maybe build up for next year if that's the case. But I hope you guys continue to do what you're doing, because it's a huge effect. It's had a huge effect on my life and in my team. So please continue to do what you guys do.
We're not going anywhere. At least not now. I know Rick and I, we got this motto about finishing strong, right?
Yeah, no doubt.
It's our goal to really finish this strong, no matter what the case is. And having the 49ers as a presenting sponsor with all of their love and their appreciation for what we're doing, from the Lynch family all the way down through their executive staff and even the players. It's been quite a joy to be a part of that. Rick, do you have anything you want to add, my friend?
You know, one of my favorite moments too with, you know, this is my usual line, Casey. I love Del Oro 363 days of the year.
Yep.
But besides that, the honor tours that we have had at Del Oro were absolutely stellar. Mm-hmm. To have those kids. And that was one of the things that we tried to do, was to engage the students, the student leadership, the media, to make this special, because it's not like we're a dog and pony to come in. Really emotional times. We've had two of them at Del Oro. And like you say, you know, Inderkum is just down the road. Mm-hmm. It's something that I believe that, you know, the public, especially on the kids' side, they're hungry for good stuff. And that's what we're hoping for, is that when we get back, we can continue being the inspiration for high school sports once again.
Yeah. Yeah. We're super excited about, we're excited about 2020. We had some great teams. We had several ESPN games ready to roll out. And then, you know, then COVID. But whatever happens, we're not going away, Case. And it excites me to know that you mentioned Inderkum and us possibly going down that way, because we're always looking for new schools, new areas to bring the Honor Bowl to, so people can see it. They can be a part of it and feel the emotion of an Honor Bowl, because it's so much more than a football game. It's what our motto is. It's more than just a football game. And you know that more than anything. I mean, I remember being sidelined with you at Del Oro when we had a jet fly over. Yeah. First time it's ever been done in high school sports. And his dad raises his hand, Jim Bell, and says, hey, I'm going to fly my jet over, right? Stuff like that, that just is history making. And we're excited about bringing this back to communities across the nation. But more than ever, Casey, we're excited to know you. And the fact that you allowed us this opportunity when we were just coaches, right? And we had an idea. You allowed us to launch it. Your school, the principal, the admin allowed us to get this started. And it was under your leadership and guidance that we were able to do this, Casey, and we'll never forget it. Matter of fact, it's a big part of my book. When that book comes out in a couple of weeks, you'll read it, and you'll see that how much I respected and appreciated the fact that you allowed us the opportunity to do this, and I'll never forget it, Casey.
Well, I appreciate that. It was a no-brainer for me, like I said, just, you know, with my dad and grandpa serving, it was just something I felt I had to do. And, you know, knowing you as a friend and knowing what you've gone through with your boys, you know, I thought, hey, at least I got somebody that kind of is where I'm at. But I didn't know you'd take it as far as we've taken it. But it's been a great ride. You know, I remember, you know, the first few, we had like 5 games in a day, and, you know, Friday night and Saturday. But we've had some great games, not only, I mean, some epic games. I know, like with Del Oro playing, you know, Westlake. I mean, played each other. It was a great game. Went to overtime. Still think it was a bad call there. I thought we scored. We lost.
I write about that in my book. Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, to share with them during the week, they had, I believe, a player or a coach that had died, you know, and we'd sharing that with them, hearing their stories and talking and getting to know them as they were here for 3 or 4 days. And then, ironically, we had great years. I think we went undefeated the way out. We won our sections. Mm-hmm. And we go to the state game at the Home Depot Center, and we played before them. And we got beat by, I don't know who, I think it was Helix that year or Baker. We lost twice down there, so I think it was Helix. And then we're walking off the field, and they're ready to play De La Salle. And to see that without the coaches saying, hey, go say anything, the kids lined up and gave each other high fives, kind of walking in and walking out, and hey, good luck. And we each had one of our decals you guys gave us for Honor Bowl. I just saw that leave, and, you know, you get beat in the state final, and you're like, you know, it hurts, you know, and then to see the kids interact and just get it over, you know, an honorable LA team and a, you know, Sacramento team, and just thinking they're buddies, you know, which it was very powerful for me. And I think that's kind of the power that the honorable can bring, that brings, you know. So that was a lot of great moments like that. So it's been a great ride, like I said, you know, and I'd like, you know, as much, whatever you guys ever need from me or would let me know, I'm in.
No, Case. I remember that one time when you guys went to Camp Pendleton. We already talked about it briefly, but I remember when you went to the Wounded Warrior Battalion and brought your kids there, and you guys got to tour the battalion, see how the wounded Marines rehabilitate, meet the commanding officer of the battalion, have him talk to you, meet the wounded. I mean, bro, we've had some great, great times together and some educational times, which is what it's all about. It's about making sure that these kids leave with an education about patriotism, and the coaches feel it, the fans feel it. It's truly an honor, Casey, and you are once again, you were the guy that raised his hand and said, hey Mark, you know, go ahead and do this, do it at our school. So we appreciate you, we appreciate all of you, your family, your friends. Congratulations on Inderkum. I'm going to be following you, my friend. Super excited to see how you do over there, and see you really bring that whole program to another realm.
Well, I appreciate it. Get up! Get some. Yeah, I'm excited. We're real excited to get over there and get rolling. Like I said, just hoping to get through this virus stuff so we can get out there and get to work. So we're excited for the opportunity, and like I said, looking forward to get after it.
God bless you, Casey. Thank you for being on Honor Radio. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Please follow Casey. We're going to have his Twitter here for you, so follow him. He's a great coach, great man, great teacher, great father, great husband, great man. And we love you, Casey. God bless you. Thank you for being on Honor Radio.
You bet. Anytime.